Welcome to my YouTube channel, which is titled Research Methods Class with Dr. Lydia Wabugo. In Research Methods, we have a book titled Research Methods, Theory and Practice. This book is accessible through the website where you can access the hard copy of the book or a downloadable PDF format of the book. In the same website, you are able to access all the courses, which includes the free research methods course, IBM SPSS statistics course, M&E consultancy course, which are available at a fee. Please find the links in the description. Welcome. Welcome to our class today, and this is a continuation of chapter 3 of the research proposal. And we have said that the chapter 3 of the research proposal is titled Research Methodology. So today we are going to look at section 3.3, which is titled Research Design. In our previous lesson, we have discussed section 3.2, which is research paradigm. And we have said a paradigm is a set of beliefs that guides researchers as they conduct research. We have also explained the three philosophical questions that a researcher should ask themselves so that they are able to select the paradigm that best answers the question so that they are able to answer the research problem. So this lesson will focus on research design, and it is section 3.3 of the research proposal. At the end of this lesson, you should be able to explain the meaning of a research design, state the elements of a research design, identify quantitative, qualitative and mixed method research designs, and explain the requirements of section 3.3. So I would urge you to go back to lesson 12 to lesson 18 and make sure you familiarize yourself with all quantitative designs, all qualitative designs, and all mixed method strategies or design. Because in this lesson, our main interest is to focus on that section of the research proposal. So again, we have the sections of chapter 3 of the research proposal. We have already discussed research design, so we are now discussing the research design. Before we discuss research design, we need to ask ourselves, can we live without planning or without a plan? And I'm sure almost all of us will say no. We plan our lives. We plan what we would want to have achieved by the end of the year, what we need to do tomorrow. So we always make a plan. And of course, once we accomplish the plan, then our lives becomes more enjoyable. In the same vein, you cannot conduct research without a plan. And the question we need to ask ourselves, therefore, is what is the plan for? The plan is to guide you as the researcher as you collect data, as you analyze, and as you interpret data in order to answer the research problem. So it means that for you to conduct research, you need to have a plan so that you know, how will I collect data? How will I sample? How will I analyze this data? And this plan is what is referred to as the research design. So research design is a master plan of how and where data are to be collected and analyzed in order to answer the research questions or test hypotheses. It can also be defined as a plan or strategy that is drawn for organizing the research and making it practicable so that research questions can be answered based on the evidence and warrants. So in simple terms, what we are talking about is that a research design constitutes the plan
or the blueprint for the collection, measurement, and analysis of data. So it is the research design that enables the researcher to collect, to analyze, and to interpret data so that the reader can now see how the research problem has been answered. Please note that there is no fit for all design in research. The selection of a design is determined by the purpose of the research, which in turn informs the methodology. And when we talk about the methodology, remember our lesson 61, we said the explanation of all these methods. For instance, if the purpose of our research is to describe the characteristics of a sample, then a survey design will be desirable. If the researcher intends to determine the effects of or impacts of a specific intervention on a sample, then an experimental design or action research design may be appropriate. If a researcher aims to have an in-depth study of a culture or of a people, then an ethnographic design might be the suitable ones. So this explains that there is no fit for all design. The purpose of the study determines the design that you are going to select for your study. So now we remind ourselves the quantitative designs that we discussed from lesson 12 to lesson 18. So we mainly have three quantitative research designs. We have survey, which can either be correlational, cross-sectional, or longitudinal. Then we have ex post facto or causal comparative research, which can either be retrospective or prospective. And then we have experimental design, which can either be true or quasi. We discussed all these designs in details. Then we have five giants of qualitative research, five qualitative designs. We have case study, we have grounded theory, we have ethnography, we have biography or narrative research, and we have phenomenology. And then we have four main mixed method research designs, all nine based on how you have defined either your mixed method or multi-method research. So you have concurrent triangulation, or concurrent nested or embedded design. Then we also have sequential explanatory design and sequential exploratory design. All we have the nine strategies that we can use based on what you are prioritizing, or what will precede what. Will they be sequential or will they be concurrent? And like I have said, all these designs, we explained them in details in lesson 12 to lesson 18. So what are you expected to write in section 3.3, which is the research design? The first one is to state the proposed design for the study. This is where you state the design and then you explain it. Of course, you start by defining it and then you explain it in details, where we are defining the basic considerations of the design. What is the design about? Are there other studies that have been anchored on this design? What are its strengths and weaknesses? Then why has the design shaped your study? And then why are you anchoring this the study on this design despite its limitations? So those are the three key issues that you need to discuss again in half a page, where you tell your reader which is the design that you have selected and why and how it has shaped your study and the other three items that we have mentioned. And this brings us to the end of our lesson, where we have talked about research design. And in simple terms, we have said research design is a plan of how you will collect, you will analyze, and interpret data. In our next lesson, we are going to discuss section 3.4 of the research proposal, which is the target population. So thank you for being part of this class. Please make sure that you subscribe to this channel. Like and share this video with your friends, and do not forget to ask any question that you have regarding this lesson in the comment section.